Darling, you sent me. I know you sent me. Darling, you sent me. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial, and this is the Android Application Development Series 5. And I'm your host Sabith, and back with another video. So today we are going to learn about using indent in Android Studio. So indent is nothing but pushing anything to do something else. So likewise, we have learned how to use a button to show a toast. So likewise, in that case, we have used the one click listener. So one click is actually a kind of indent, but it's not actually declared as an indent. So anyways, so we have the first application, our project in the Android Studio. I'm opening it. So everything is ready. What I'm going to do is simply adding a button into the workspace. So here is a button. Now let's move to the text. We have the button with name, and here is the ID as same as button. So I'm using a relative layout, and I highly recommend changing the constrained layout into relative layout. So once you have done, all you have to do is just move to the main activity. As we have discussed in the previous video, we have to declare the button, naming it as BT. Now moving to the BT. So now we have declared the button in the onCreate method. Now what we have to do next is that we're gonna be using the indent inside this button one click listener. So let's type bt.setOneClickListener. If you don't know what is one click listener, you probably stop this video at this point and watch the previous video. Okay, so let's continue. Equal to new one click listener. So inside, you can see when I type it, when I completely type it, you can see here is a one click method, which is actually a kind of indent that pushes the button to do something else. So now we have to introduce the new guy into our Android app development series. So that is indent. So indent equal to, and I'm typing a name for the indent, like base we have what we have done at the button case, that we used the BT as the name of this button. Likewise, I'm using the indent. Then my indent, you can give your own name no matter what the name of the variable is, equal to new indent. So here is a pop-up message which shows that there is no parameters or arguments, and indent or string action URI context package context, that's class file, blah blah blah. So what we are going to do is that today we are going to open a second activity using a button click. So when I learned Android programming, it was one of my dream to develop an Android app with a button, and when the user press the button, it will show a birthday card. So likewise, so in this case, all you have to do is that in the bracket, you have to simply type the class name. So which the class is main activity. Okay. Now dot this. So as I have said before, the Java is a high level programming language which is almost similar to our English words like this, do, indent, and many other things. Okay, let's continue by adding a comma. Now add a space and type the second activity name. I want to name the second activity as, so now I'm typing the class dot class, and finally closing by a semicolon and adding the second line as start activity. So in the case of indent, we have to also add a start activity and the indent variable name inside that. So start activity, the indent variable name is indent. So now what we have to do is just go to the app, go to Java, go to res, open the both files. So now right click on the res, go to new, and now go to activity, and from here you have to select the empty activity. Now give the name that we have given at this point, so that is second activity. So second activity, you don't have to add the class or .java or any other extensions. Now the layout name is second activity, you don't have to do anything here. Package name is same as that one. Click on the finish. Okay, now we got another class file with a XML file. Now let's move to the main activity again, and you can see the red error has been taken down. Okay, likewise, now we have added a indent, and the indent is forcing the button to open the second activity, which is this one, second activity.java, and the corresponding to the second activity here is the activity underscore second.xml as the activity file which we have seen here. It is already described. Now let's move to the second activity. Now I'm again changing the constrained layout with relative layout. Okay, so now let's go to the design. I'm dragging a text view into the center. Again, go to the text, changing the text view into, okay, so here is a happy birthday text view message, changing the size into 36 again, bold, and text color, going to the color, selecting the most appropriate color from here. Okay, so that's just better. You can also add the color using hex color method, like hash then your color code. Okay, so that's for this tutorial. Let's come to the conclusion. So what we have done is simply added a button inside the activity underscore main.xml, then moved to the main activity.java. We have implemented the button bt and declared the button, name of the button as bt. So bd is a find, that is a button. We have added the find view by id method again, and we have added one click listener for the bd, and inside the one click method we have introduced a new guy which is indent. So we have given the name of the indent as my indent, and here it is declared. And finally, we have added the activity names to be done with this indent file. So finally, and once that done, we have added start activity, and in the bracket we use it the indent name. So that's for now. Let's go and run it in a live device and check that out. So when I press the button, wow, it's to open the second activity, which shows that happy birthday. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this tutorial. If you like this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up. And if you want to watch the upcoming series, make sure that you have done the subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next video.